Tyler Stem, 152, senior captain.
Brandon Molnar, weight class 182, year senior.
John DePasquale, senior captain, 138.
Augie Savarese, 113, senior.
Christian Kyleide, heavyweight, senior.
Alyssa Maturo, senior manager.
Austin Weiss, 145, senior.
Christopher Dumont, 145, senior.
Ashton Payne, 132, senior.
Ben Durst, captain, 120, senior.
Ryan Molnar, 160, senior.
My name's Gerald Nelson, 126, and I'm a senior.
Ed Novak, 160, senior year.
Hello and welcome back to Simsbury Wrestling for the most monumental match of their career this year. Today, the Simsbury Trojans will be taking on the Farmington Indians in a divisional matchup that will decide the CCC West tournament winners here. As you can see behind me, Simsbury is currently warming up for what will be their biggest match this year. Simsbury Wrestling team has worked as hard as they ever have in the years of the Simsbury Wrestling team being around. Never has the Simsbury Wrestling team been so close to having an undefeated record. If Simsbury can win this one, they will have the only undefeated record of a Simsbury Wrestling team. Once again, Simsbury, currently ranked number 2, is taking on the Farmington Indians, ranked number 4. Both squads are undefeated, and both squads are looking to get their first undefeated season. If Simsbury is able to win this one, they will be capturing their first conference championship since 2001. For Farmington, they are looking to win their first CCC West title and its first league championship since winning a share of the Northwest Conference in 2007. This is also the senior night of the Simsbury Trojans.
The senior on the wrestling team, with Simsbury wrestling team, along with their parents, gathered over on the wall with the championship banners. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Simsbury High School, the home of the Simsbury High School Wrestling Team. Tonight, the number 2 ranked Trojans welcome the number 4 ranked Indians from Farmington High School in the CCC West Championship Match. Welcome to the athletes, parents, and fans from Farmington. Tonight is also our senior night here at Simsbury, and we will be honoring our seniors for their dedication and commitment to Simsbury Wrestling right now. We appreciate their hard work and the dedication the seniors have shown through their 4 years. They will be greatly missed. We would also like to thank the senior parents for their support
the hours spent sitting in the bleachers, contributing food to the concession stand, and other assistance to the program that has helped build up Simsbury Wrestling. And so, without any further ado, I'd like to announce our first senior, Trevor Aaron, escorted by Nancy and Michael Aaron.
Trevor has been wrestling 4 years for the Simsbury wrestling team. Chris Dumont has also wrestled 4 years for the Simsbury wrestling squad. This is Ashton Payne's first year of wrestling in the Simsbury squad.
Next up is senior Gerald Nelson, escorted by Gerald Senior and Dorothy Lewis.
Gerald Nelson has wrestled all 4 years in the Simsbury squad, and majority of them on the varsity squad. August Savarese has wrestled all 4 years in the Simsbury squad, and the majority of them on the varsity squad.
Next up, senior brothers Ryan and Brandon Molnar, escorted by Stephen Collett Molnar.
Both Ryan and Brandon have both wrestled on the Simsbury squad for 4 years. Brandon this year actually placed second at the Skip Barton and third at the Frank Shaves tournament.
Our next honoree, senior Austin Weeks, escorted by Renee and Phil Weeks.
Austin has wrestled 4 years in the Simsbury squad and is currently wrestling at the varsity 145-pound weight class this year. Christian Kylide has wrestled 2 years in the Simsbury squad. Last year he took home All-American honors and placed second at the Double L tournament. This year he has placed first at the Skip Barton tournament and second at the Fairfield Ward tournament.
Next up, senior Captain Benders, escorted by Jay Benders.
Benders also has wrestled in the squad for 4 years. He was an academic All-American in the previous year. Placed fifth in state opens in the previous year as well.
Our next honoree, senior Captain John DePasquale, escorted by Captain Phil DePasquale.
John DePasquale has wrestled all 4 years of his high school career and placed third in both Skip Barton and Fairfield Ward this year.
Our next honoree, senior Captain Tyler Stem, escorted by Mary and David Stem.
Tyler Stem has wrestled 3 years in the Simsbury wrestling squad, and in this previous year he placed first at Frank Shaves and second at the Skip Barton tournament.
Our next honoree is senior Captain Ed Nomad, escorted by Christine.
Ed Novak has wrestled 3 years in the Simsbury squad. In this previous year, he placed first at Skip Barton and second at Fairfield Ward.
Our next honoree, senior manager Kelly Nisel, escorted by Stacy and Russell Nisel.
Kelly Nisel has managed for the last 2 years of the Simsbury squad.
And our final honoree this evening, senior
Alyssa Mataro has managed all 4 years for the Simsbury squad.
We want to thank all of our seniors for their loyalty, hard work, and sacrifice to make Simsbury Wrestling one of the best teams in our state. Thank you, seniors. And now, if we can get about the business of the evening, our teams, if they can line up on either side of the mat, we'll have the introduction.
Through the night that our flag was
tonight. Seems like the best time as ever to let my co-host introduce himself.
Thanks, Spencer. Roger Coombs here, helping out a little bit wrestling night. Been watching you guys, Spencer, on SCTV this year. Just done a fabulous job. We had our maiden voyage last year, Spence, yep. Remember? And you and Mr. Helmkamp, John Helmer, have taken over just fantastically. So I'm honored that you guys asked me to come up here. Coach Goodwin asked me to come on up if I had a minute, and I appreciate you letting me up here, Spencer. This is your show. Just here to add a little bit of color, hopefully not off color. I'll leave the wheelbarrows and the chicken wings and all those wrestling moves to you, Brick.
It's great to have you here tonight.
Thanks.
All right, and this is going to be a great matchup tonight. I mean, I know in the past we've always talked about how great matchups are going to be, you know, about how well matched teams are, but this is probably the best team we've seen all year. One of the best teams. We just match up so well with them. And really, through and through, this is going to be a dogfight tonight.
Unbelievable, Spencer, you know, and this gym is packed. The lighting, I love the way they center up the lighting over the mat. It's just a very exciting feeling. I had goosebumps. I'm not trying to be corny, but when they were doing some of those introductions, it was really cool.
Oh, yeah, this is one of the biggest nights the Simsbury Trojans have had in their entire time in existence.
Wow. And that's coming from a former Trojan grappler in Spencer Bricky. Hey, let's not forget about our new cameraman tonight, Adam Rozdowski, on the camera. He's fresh off of journalism, a graduate degree out of Syracuse. Big A, thanks for joining us tonight.
Great to have you here.
Yeah, really appreciate it. So, man, unbelievable. This is going to be great. So, Spencer, there won't ever be any of those open weight class forfeits at all. They're going to send up somebody if it's the coach's grandmother.
Mm-hmm. This is a fight to, you know, a fight to end all fights right here.
So we got Simsbury's James DeMayo up on the mat first. Spence, and I remember last time, and I don't want to interrupt your shows, but they start at one weight class somewhere. They randomly pick it, and then they go at a serpentine from there?
Exactly. Before the match starts, a weight is chosen randomly, usually in a box of popsicle sticks. And from there, they start at that weight, and they just loop back around to the other weight.
I really like that, Spencer, because it takes the pressure off if they go lowest weight to upper weight, you know,
exactly.
It takes the pressure off.
That's the reason why they changed the system. Is again, you had these heavyweights that were always the match always ended on them,
It
seems like a more fair system.
Absolutely.
All right, and this is a really good match right here. James DeMayo, you know, he's had a good year this year. He wrestled at 135 last year, much smaller weight class. He's actually bulked up a lot to get up to this weight, but he's done very, very well.
And Brick, what weight class is this?
Right now, this is 170 pounds.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
He went up 25 pounds in 1 year.
Yep.
James DeMayo.
He gave so much time in the offseason to really get bigger, get to a larger size. You know, he wanted to wrestle at a higher weight class. He felt he was more comfortable at a higher weight class, and it's been working for him thus far this year.
That's unbelievable. And I think that's one of the resounding, reoccurring messages we'll hear tonight, Spencer, is how hard these Simsbury Trojan wrestlers do work.
Oh, I mean, the schedule that we wrestled this season is just unmatched. I mean, we took on at least 5 to 6 of the top 10 teams in the state, and we just fought them with everything we had. You know, we never gave an inch, no matter what match. And that's why we are now sitting at this match undefeated. You know, we gave every wrestler, every practice, gave everything he got. And, you know, we're starting to reap the work that we had right now.
Unbelievable. Well, good, then. You'll help us with all the scoring like you've been doing all year. I got the scoreboard here. I might ask some silly questions about some of the scoring, but maybe being a novice as I am might help some of the viewers who don't typically watch wrestling.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
But if you guys are watching this match, as Spencer said, this is some exciting stuff right here.
Oh, yeah, this is the most packed I've ever seen for a wrestling match, and for, you know, good reasons.
And I'm sure you dressed it up that Simsbury's number 2 in the state and Farmington's number 3. And Coach Goodwin, I think, you know, in his seventh or eighth year, is it? From Glastonbury.
Yeah. Whoa. This is also for Coach Goodwin his first chance at having an undefeated season in all his years of being a coach for both here and actually previously Glastonbury.
Yep, where he came from and then started this to really rebuild the Trojan program. Did you wrestle for him, Brick?
I was actually his freshman class. My freshman class was his first year. And again, he just, what he's done for this team, rebuilding this team. I mean, when he first came in, I mean, we were as despaired as a team could really be. All right, and that's a one escape point right there for James DeMayo.
Wow.
Now you see how they set up right there?
Yeah.
Especially when they have the underhooks and overhooks with that. That means that one of the wrestlers is looking for a throw. It can be a dangerous position for some wrestlers, but DeMayo has a lot of experience. He really knows how to throw himself. He knows how to stay safe in that position.
I see.
Once again, the Farmington wrestler tries to get the over and under hooks here.
And Spencer, when are they both out of bounds?
They're both out of bounds when at least two parts of both wrestlers have pushed out of bounds.
Okay. This appears to be kind of is it a feeling out process? It seems like neither wrestler's really taking any aggressive position.
Well, what actually is happening right now, and that's, kind of the great complexity of wrestling, is a lot of times it doesn't look like they're doing much. Right here, as you can see, what they're doing, locking arms and stuff, they're trying to set up a shot. That's half of wrestling is setups.
Okay.
And right now, as you see, the Farmington wrestler looks like he's trying to attempt a throw. That seems to be what he wants to get out of the Simsbury wrestler.
So to get low leg, to pick up and
exactly.
spin.
But again, James DeMayo is such an experienced wrestler, he's not going to allow it to happen.
Yep.
He has a wide base, not allowing himself to get thrown. He keeps his center of gravity low, makes sure that he can't be thrown anywhere.
Spencer, DeMayo's been pushed to the out of bounds each time. Is that because this Farmington wrestler is physically stronger?
I wouldn't say physically stronger, but DeMayo is focusing on being defensive.
And not letting him get what he wants.
Exactly. So a lot of times that'll, he's not consciously going to edge him out. It's just what's happening because of the actions that he's doing right here.
Sure.
See, there's the throw that the Farmington wanted to attempt.
Is that a point?
That was actually no point right there. That was, wasn't the greatest throw from the Farmington wrestler. He landed on his back, but DeMayo was not able to capitalize down there and land on top.
Wow.
It appears that the Farmington wrestler loves throws. He's been focusing on trying to get the over-under hook and throw James DeMayo to the mat. But again, because DeMayo is such an experienced wrestler, years of youth wrestling under his belt, he knows how to stay in good position, not allow anything to happen. All right, and that's 1 point for Farmington. We now have a tied score. All right, and see what happened there is DeMayo wasn't able to pay attention right off the bat, and the Farmington wrestler was able to get the throw there.
Throw he picked up two, and then it went to six.
Yeah, what happened is he got the one for escaping, and then he threw him. He got two for a takedown and three back punch. You might have noticed that the ref was throwing his hands up, counting seconds.
I see.
After 5 seconds, it's worth 3 points.
And Spencer, how many periods are there in the match for each
wrestler? There are 3 periods.
Okay. Wow. What a tough sport.
It is. It is grueling.
Wow.
Now what DeMayo needs to do here, as you see at the Farmington wrestler trying to push his foot in, his leg in there right there. You see that?
Yes.
What DeMayo needs to do is try to kick out that leg and start working to get back up.
Wow. He's trying to feel for it a little bit.
Yep. Farmington wrestler,
he's got him locked
position.
On.
Yep.
He's got that left leg locked. Farmington.
See, DeMayo's
wrestler.
Trying to straighten out his leg. He's trying to break it through.
Wow.
Now, what happened there is a lot of times is if no action is happening over a certain amount of time, usually about 10 to 15 seconds, the ref will call a stalemate. Pretty much stand them back up and put them back into a neutral position.
I see. with 50 seconds left in this core, in this period, this wrestling match, when do wrestlers ever become clock managing? You don't really get the chance to look at the clock much.
Not much. And especially as a wrestler, it's you listen for your coach to yell to you to tell you how much time is left.
Of course.
You know, it's how much.
Maybe in between, like right now, you might gander up. Like, I noticed the Farmington wrestler seems to look at the clock on each break.
Yeah, every time you break, you can look up again while you're wrestling. It's important that you don't focus on the clock.
So with the 6-1 lead, 29 ticks, does the Farmington wrestler play very cautious and not get pinned accidentally?
It would be the smart idea for Farmington to just keep the points up right now. Because, it's sort of the thing where, you know, a backed-up animal is the most dangerous animal. You don't want to put yourself in a position where the losing wrestler is able to push his way through.
Because that's what James DeMeo, in this situation, our Trojan wrestler, has to do. He's got to do something really spectacular.
Looks like he's running out of time, though, and not exactly the strongest start for Simsbury.
What a tough battle by James DeMeo, going from 135 weight class last year to 170. Spencer, that's incredible.
And you know, that really proves about wrestling is it's a split second sport. You know, DeMeo lost his attention for a split second, was thrown right there.
Wow. Roz, how you doing, dude? All right? Good.
Yeah. So my feet wet, I guess.
Yeah.
I did a lot of close-ups on the first one, so I think I'm sort of just getting my feel for doing
this. And don't forget Coach Goody over there too. Coach Goody.
Yeah, Brandon Molnar here at 182. It's actually his first varsity season. He's actually been doing quite amazing for his, you know, he's a senior, but again, he's done very, very well for a first varsity wrestler.
Wow.
You know, he's deceptively strong and technical.
Hey, James DeMeo, is he a sophomore?
He is a sophomore.
Yeah, so that's a good battle by the sophomore, James DeMeo, there. And to start out first has got to be tough.
It can be. First and last are never fun.
So, James, you know, great effort, James D.
All right, there currently looks like Brandon was trying to go for a front headlock, was not able to get it, and now both wrestlers are fighting for hand control currently. All right, the Farmington wrestler looked like he attempted a boot scoot there, wasn't able to get it. Molnar held onto the legs and they went out of bounds.
Wow. I love some of your moves. The wheelbarrow, the chicken wing, I like that one.
They're fun names.
Definitely. And everyone who knows wrestling what's going on. Same as in most sports, huh?
Yeah.
That's great. Do you like having, from a broadcasting standpoint, being in the blue gym versus the new gym versus the old gym?
I'm liking this gym right now. You know, it's much more spacious, able to move around a little more, I guess. You know, I will say the blue gym gets very, very hot, especially when you have such a big crowd.
Yeah. This is a great angle where we are now, where Adam's got the camera. Yeah. He's bringing this action to you right into your living rooms.
All right, and we see right here we have blood time. The Simsbury wrestler got a cut on the forehead. Mm. Right now he has time to clean up. Now with blood time and injury time, you have 5 minutes to pretty much recuperate from there.
Wow.
Yeah, with injury time, it can be a little bit more wonkier because if you got injured because of an illegal move and you're not able to recover in 5 minutes, it becomes your win. But with blood time and injury time that's caused by just a normal fall or something like that, after 5 minutes, if you're not able to recuperate, the other team gets the win. And the win for over amount of injury time or blood time is actually 6 points. So it's actually a huge victory. But again, I have very, very rarely in my years of both wrestling and coaching wrestling seen a match stop because of too much blood time.
Sure. And you saw the trainer, Chris, rapping Molnar just to shut down any potential blood.
Yeah.
Coach Goodwin was talking to the referee. Taking that opportunity, getting his ear a little bit.
Exactly. Again, you see the Farmington wrestler likes keeping hand control right there. Now, I've noticed he likes to do, he grabs hand control, and then a lot of times he likes to reach up for that tricep right there and drag him.
Wow.
Now, drag is, again, when you pretty much drag the arm, putting him in a better position for yourself. You pretty much drag and get him off balance, try to get around him.
And Spencer, this is 182.
This is 182.
Wow. Wow.
And he's able to get the takedown there.
And that's 1 point?
That was 2 points.
2 points. Wow.
And Molnar was not able to escape. He only had a very short amount of time there.
Sure. And we start period two. 2 minute periods. Three of them.
Staying smart here. Now, a lot of times if your opponent tries to stand up and you don't feel you have a good enough grip to try to bring him back down, you go for a single. Problem right there, though, is if you're not strong in a single, a lot of times you get reversed, which just happened to him.
Wow. And that was two more points.
Mm-hmm. Now, see, when he gets flattened right there, it's a very, very dangerous position for a wrestler to be in. You want to be up in a base. You have a better chance to pretty much push and escape. When you're on your stomach right there, you're pretty much you're in the worst possible position. You leave yourself open to pinning combinations, which, again, the Farmington wrestler is attempting right here.
I see. But he's got to flip him to pin him, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That looks like he's going for a cradle right now.
Get the legs in there and give a little body flip.
As you see, much use his arms to pull his knee to his head, kind of like how you cradle a child.
I think that would be done a little more loving fashion.
Yes, with a little less muscle.
and a right forearm under his neck.
Yeah.
Look at that.
See, now he's done the right thing here. He's worked back into a base. He has plenty of room to try and escape, which he's trying right now.
Wow. 23 seconds left in the second period. 4-0, still, this match is still very much alive.
Yep.
So 4-0, Farmington after two periods. Brandon Molnar, the senior, working hard at 182 pounds, needs to get on the board.
He needs to try to get points here. You know, also, what they might be trying to do here, and this happens a lot with wrestling, is if you know your opponent, you know, the coach knows the opponent is you know, has many more years of experience, is, you know, a very powerful wrestler. A lot of times, they will have their wrestler wrestle so that he doesn't give up too many points. Because after 8 points, it's considered a major. Now, major is worth 14 points.
Wow.
After that, over 15 points is considered a tech fall, which pretty much means so many points, it's pretty much forfeit. You know, like in baseball, where over a certain amount of points in Little League, they just stop the game.
Yep.
Same thing with wrestling.
Now, wow, Spencer, that's a very big strategy decision for Coach Goodwin.
Exactly. It's better to put him in the position where he's, you know, he's not, doesn't have a great position to win, but he also is avoiding giving up points.
Wow.
And again, you know, this is, you know, he's called for stalling. Now, stalling is where pretty much the ref decides that you're not doing enough on, you know, not doing enough on your part. You're not doing enough, you know, you're not being active enough, and he'll call you for stalling. Now, you get a warning at first.
I see.
After that, it's 1 point. The third stalling is another point. Fourth is 2 points. Five, the match ends.
Okay. And Spencer, he'd be stalling Molnar right now so he doesn't get the whitewashed or the skunk.
Exactly, yeah. He's pretty much staying in a tight base.
Defensive mode.
Yeah, keeping him completely defensive, not allowing any shots in.
Yep.
You know, and at this point in the match, you know, this is a very strong opponent he's wrestling. It's smart wrestling. It's keeping the Farmington wrestler from being able to grab too many extra points here. Now he's got 1 point for stalling.
Really?
So, still, there's about 3 points he would need to get before it'd be a major.
That's a very discretionary call, yes. Isn't it, by the referee. Two more there?
He needs three more currently. 8 points for it to be a major.
Okay, there were no points awarded there.
None there.
And we have 29 seconds left. 5-0, yes. Farmington.
Once again, the smartest thing for Molnar to do right now is, well, actually it counts. It counts if the ref decides to give another stalling point. If he gives another stalling point, Molnar's in a little bit more trouble because if the Farmington wrestler is then able to take him down, he gets the major. It might be kind of smart to allow himself in the last 10 seconds to be taken down and then let it be a one-point match. See? Now it's a one-point match with 8 seconds left.
Wow.
Yes.
And that number we don't want is 8. We don't want 8.
We don't want any turn.
Because then it goes to 14 overall.
Exactly.
Wow.
See? The smart thing right now for Molnar to do is to just stay
strong.
Pop
up like he did, but don't stall.
Yep. Actually, you know what? Right there, he had the opportunity to stall because he was given one escape point. But again, it didn't really matter. Short amount of time. Simsbury only gives up 3 there.
Wow.
Again, from an outside view, it might look like a stupid decision. You pretty much gave up a loss. But what he did there is pretty much allow the team to not give up any extra points. Now, it's the chess match that is wrestling.
Good description. No. Jake Gardner. Jake Feldman, thank you. Wow.
All right. Wow. Quick hard start to the beginning of this match.
I'll say. Oh my lord.
But again, smart defensive wrestling by the Simsbury wrestler.
Got what weight class?
This is 195.
195. Jake's a freshman. No, he's a sophomore.
Sophomore, yes.
He's a big boy.
Oh yeah. He had himself in a little bit of danger there, but you know, he got caught off guard at the very beginning of the match, but he wrestled smart there. He wrestled smart defense.
Wow. Big Jake Feldman plays football, too, for the Trojans. Good quarterback. Geez, he looks about 6'2", 6'1", good 6'1", 195. Oh, yeah. He's a big boy.
He has had an amazing sophomore year here on this team. You know, he's wrestled hard throughout every single match. You know, been very, very productive.
Yep.
Got a lot of wins this year. You know, it's been probably one of the better sophomore seasons that this team has seen in a while for any wrestler.
Nice. Yeah, Spence, I've coached a lot of basketball and baseball with my two boys through the years, so I don't know guys who didn't do those two sports, and Jake was a great football player.
Oh, and that's a beautiful single he got right there.
Wow.
Now, what he needs to do is keep sucking it in here.
Did he already secure one point?
Corner, try to grab the second leg and turn the corner.
Wow.
Yep, he's got it up now. Smart. Good smart wrestling there. That was a beautiful shot by the Simsbury wrestler.
Yeah, Jake. Now he's got to be, look at him.
He got the ankle.
He looked like a little schoolgirl on the playground, that kid there, didn't he?
He got, you know, Farmington is able to get the escape, but still, that was a smart wrestling by Jake. You know, he pretty much let him go. He didn't allow it to be more than 2 points, or more than 1 point.
Spencer, I think I know the answer, but their momentum does exist in wrestling,
doesn't
it? Oh,
exactly, momentum.
Right now, Jake's not, he's feeling good. He's getting up there, and he needs to continue where he left off with the momentum.
I would go and say that at least 20 to 30% of wrestling is momentum. It's that confidence. Wrestling is almost all confidence, you know.
Yep.
That you can't lay in the laurels of any of your teammates.
Sure.
You have to have self-confidence at all times. And again, getting takedowns really helps. Oh, and he's got double legs in here. What he needs to do is try to break down his opponent. Like he did right there.
Oh, look at that.
Beautifully done.
You can press down on the head like that?
Yep. What he wants to do right here is he's trying
pull
to get
up.
Yep.
Oh my
he's
goodness.
He's trying to get a power half. He's in good position for it. He's in great position. What he needs to do is try to keep his legs strong, not allow the Farmington wrestler to push back into his base. See? He's smart here.
Spencer, head touch is fair game.
It's fine as long as one hand underneath the arm. A second hand under the arm, it's a dangerous move. Now see, right here, he needs to try to push his hips back up on top. He's in a little bit of a dangerous spot, but now he's in a better spot now.
Wow.
Yep.
Well, I'd be careful of getting flipped here.
Exactly. It's a little bit of a dangerous position. See, smart wrestling from the Simsbury wrestler.
He's frog-legging him.
Yep.
Yeah.
Taking the hands out from underneath his Farmington opponent.
Who's jumping forward on that move, Jake or this Farmington wrestler?
Who's what?
Jumping forward, getting from the... Whose
what
body
actually
most?
Jake is doing is he's ripping the arms underneath from Farmington and squeezing down.
Yep, yep. And that Farmington guy goes flat.
Oh! And that's what happened there.
Is that a...
Yep, that's
oh, he
just,
got two for that.
Yep. That was just bad hip position.
Wow.
That can happen a lot of times with the wrestlers. They forget that their hips are laying on the mat and they get into dangerous positions.
Strong play by the Farmington wrestler.
Mm-hmm. And Feldman escapes here. It's now a tie score again. Feldman's got to be looking for shots.
Oh, he gets one for that escape. Oh, that's cool. 24 seconds in the second period. 3-3.
There's a good chance we're not going to see any shots at the end here.
What do you mean by shots?
Shots as in them going in for legs, then trying to bring their opponent down to the ground.
Too risky.
A lot of times with this low amount of time right here, they're just going to pretty much let it go. That was a little bit of a sloppy shot from Farmington, though. He's got himself in a little bit of a dangerous position, but ran out of time.
Okay.
Sometimes you'll see that, too. 5 seconds left, they'll take a shot.
He's
at the end of bad position. There's not really enough time for them to lose it.
Woo-hoo-hoo! I love Coach Goody. He's calm as a cucumber over there. And Coach Kenny Parra sitting there in the chairs right there.
Kind of the opposite of a cucumber a lot of times.
Ooh.
Get out of bounds and bring him back in the center.
I'm not saying Coach Goody doesn't get fired up, but.
Oh, he will.
Oh, he will.
This is, we're seeing the calm before the storm right now.
Yep. Look, Coach Ernie Goodwin, physical education teacher here at the high school, just a great guy. Voice, the new voice of the Simsbury Trojans football. And a great, great guy and mentor to these boys.
Right, Jake's starting to work up. Smart wrestling.
Wow, 3-3. Spencer, do you feel either wrestler has an edge right now with 1:39 left in this thing?
Right now, Simsbury has the edge just in the fact that they are in such a prime position to score. He escapes, he gets 1 point, he's now in the lead.
How do you choose who's up and down on these?
Now, how it starts at the very beginning of the match, there's a coin toss. And from there, it's decided from there. That's a beautiful switch attempt. He's almost got it. He needs to clear his leg right there to try and get it. Looks like he's trying for a different move right here. He's smart. He's wrestling smart.
Escape?
Right, he got his one. He was trying to go for two. Ooh. He got one. But he is still up at this match.
Boy, while you're going for that kill move, you got to make sure your opponent does not get out.
Exactly.
In a tight match. That's the lead.
He has the lead right now. Farmington wrestler, again, it's the idea of backed up animals, the most dangerous animal. He's going to start taking wild shots at Jake. And again, a lot of times that can be in Simsbury's favor right here is because they're going to be sloppier shots. But they're also going to be throwing him with 100% behind them. He's got to be safe here.
Oh!
He's got to be smart.
Jake Feldman with a 1 point lead. 1 minute left. 1 minute. Boy, they're exhausted. Oh, man.
Not able to get it. Jake needs to stay smart here. He can be able to score 2 points if he wrestles intelligently
here.
Jake is in good position. He's got his legs back. He's got a three-quarter Nelson right here.
Need this one.
He switched it off. He's now got a cross face.
Let's go, Jake.
The short amount of time. He's able to get the two. This might be able to score him
six,
the victory
three,
right here.
6-3, 27 seconds.
Now he's up by two. Smart wrestling.
We needed this match, Rick.
This is definitely the momentum swing we needed.
Jake Feldman, sophomore, is about ready to deliver the goods for Coach Goodwin.
But
and
short
the
time right here, about 10 seconds, he has to stay safe. That's what I see. Strong base. He's not allowed any shots in from the Farmington wrestler. Good for him. It looks like the Farmington wrestler is just as tired as
6-4. Yeah. Now, is that still 3 points, Rick?
Yeah, that is 3 points for us.
Yes.
We're not in the lead yet, but again, that win helps.
The 195 class goes to Trojan grappler, sophomore Jake Feldman. Way to go, Jacob.
And again, good win for Simsbury. And again, wins like that, they might not be so much of a momentum switcher, but it gets the win starting to go. You know?
Absolutely.
If you string three of those in a row, boom, that gets you going. They get you in the win column.
Absolutely. You know, that's a big one. We needed that,
yeah,
Rick.
That's how Simsbury's been wrestling this entire year, though. You know, we're not a flashy team. We're not a team that's looking to show off. We're a hardworking, dirty, hardworking team. You know, we're nose down to the ground. Going to work as hard as we can.
Folks, we got Brad Helmkamp at the 220, 225?
220.
220. This is going to be a battle. I saw these guys get announced, Spencer, and I looked up at somebody. I just shook my head. Wow.
Brad is just a powerful, powerful wrestler. I mean, his double leg, again, from years and years of football, his double leg is just amazing. You know, when he wants to throw it, he's going to get it. You're not, you know, you can't stop that double leg when it's coming in.
I bet. Brad's a junior. Fullback and middle linebacker for the football team.
See, I mean, you know, he's at the edge of that right there, but, you know, he was driving his opponent perfectly there.
Brad was All-State this year in football. First team All-State.
I saw that, you know, and again, he's just a very, very athletic kid. You know, he's, you know, he does all these sports. You know, he loves competing, and you can see it out on the mat.
He works hard, too. I've coached baseball with his dad for 12, 14 years. And his mom, Wendy, dad, John, great folks. His brother, Josh, is a sophomore at Williams College, plays football for him.
Actually, this weekend.
Ooh.
Yep. Oh.
A Helmer. Flip him, Helmer.
Yep. He's sucking in that single right there.
Ooh.
He's in
gotta
good
get to
position.
That other leg.
Yep. He might be able to suck up
so
the single.
You don't want to give that leg up, do you,
yep,
Spence?
Oh, no. Keep that. What he's trying to do is trying to suck that single up into his armpit and then trip him down. See, he's starting to do it here.
Wow.
Yep. What he wants to do. Yep.
Woo!
Beautiful. That was a beautiful motion by the Simsbury wrestler.
Yeah, Helmer. He got two there. He got two there.
He got two.
Pound
and he's keeping
him,
his opponent
Helmer
down. He's being smart here.
18 seconds in the first period.
Right. He lets him up, lets that one point out. He's staying safe. Actually, this past weekend, Brad wrestled the number one 220-pounder in the state and actually went to overtime with him. It was a very, very triple overtime, actually. Very close match. You know, he didn't win, but it was a great confidence booster for him. You know?
What team is that guy from?
Glastonbury. You know, the previous time they met, Brad had, you know, had a rough time with him, mm-hmm, you know, got mm-hmm beat pretty mm-hmm pretty hard. But again, that last match, it showed his improvement throughout the season. You know, really a big confidence booster for that wrestler.
Well, after one period, 2-1, Helmkamp Trojans.
Yep.
Over Farmington Warriors. Yep. Indians, I'm sorry.
Yep.
Ooh, boy, Helmer's in that.
Yep.
Ooh. Now, by tossing him out, Spence, that eliminates that nice hold he had. You want to spin him to the middle to do
that. Exactly. The thing with that throw out there is it's kind of a gray area. You know, there's been things where throwing off the mat is considered unsportsmanlike, things like that.
Okay.
But that was borderline just because it was more or less he let go of his leg and let him go. But either way, he's able to get his one here.
Oh, okay. I keep forgetting about those escapes.
Oh, yeah.
Those can add up.
Those are actually
difference in a match.
Those are my forte back in high school. That's how I won most of my matches were escape points. Because again, they're I always thought them as free points.
Yeah,
because
agree.
All you have to do is just break free and you get that point.
That's neat.
And currently, that escape point has got him up by two.
Yep. Minute 18, the second period, 6-3 Farmington after three wrestlers. This is wrestler four. In tonight's lineup, it's the 225 weight. So I think we'll have Christian Kylide on deck.
Yep, Christian Kylide is up next.
And then we go down to the lowest.
And we go back down to 106. It's definitely a shocking change to go from heavyweight down to 106.
I bet it is.
Oh, yeah.
Good student section tonight over here. Maybe it's some JV wrestlers, perhaps. Yeah.
It's good to see that the Simsbury students actually came out in droves for this match. Usually we don't see too much fans. I mean, we have our fans, but, you know, it's good to see that they really came out fully for this big match.
Well, this is my office, you know, Spencer, for SCTV basketball. I was here last night, senior night for us against New Britain, and we beat them.
Oh, great. Oh, a bad shot from the Farmington wrestler. He attempted a fireman's throw. Didn't work out for him. Brad's
ooh
in a good position right here.
Ooh,
he's got 1 foot good. He's being smart with it. Switching off to a double.
Oh.
Beautiful move.
Oh, Helmer.
Yeah.
Now what he wants to do is climb up the body of the Farmington wrestler and try to get a half.
Whoa!
Ran out of time. That was a beautiful doubling.
Oh, man.
Again, even moves can change the momentum. You know, you get your team riled up, and that was a momentum-changing move.
And that Farmington wrestler extended his left arm.
Exactly.
That could be a broken bone right there.
Exactly.
Why does he do that? Why not just land on the shoulder? Then you're going to get rolled in pain.
Exactly. That's kind of the wrestler mentality.
Yeah.
Do whatever you can to stop him going to your back.
I see. Yeah, absolutely.
Even breaking the norm.
No doubt. Wow. And Helmekamp picked up 225 over his head.
Oh, exactly. Again, he's just a powerful, strong, hard
wrestler. You can't
throw that
guy down as hard as you want.
It's as long as you keep control of him the entire way down, it's fine. If you pick him up and let him go purposely throw him,
So it's more of a drive.
Exactly, yeah. You pick up and you drive with your shoulder.
Wow.
Which he did perfectly there.
This is fun. Big Adam Rostowski on the camera, working it like a professional.
He's got that double again.
Oh!
Picks it back up. Able to get his two.
Got two, so 7-1.
Yeah. Oh, exactly.
So, Spence, we got 1 minute and 10 seconds to get this thing to 8, and we pick up 14, and we take the lead, right?
Exactly.
Oh, my goodness. What a turnaround that would be. Wow, that seems like a lot of points.
Oh,
you had a 17-6 after 6-3 off one match?
Yeah.
Really? This could be huge.
This is a great match.
Or three match.
Oh, yeah. No, this is a big match. It's definitely going to help push us up.
Wow. Come on, Helmer. And now this Farmington wrestler is playing defense right now.
Right now, what the Farmington wrestler should be doing is looking for offense. But again, that'll happen a lot of times with a wrestler is he loses the confidence. He's now wrestling not to lose, not to lose badly. That's all that's
thinking
in his mind. Yeah. You know,
he's
not out there, like he was in the first period, trying to get those takedowns, pushing as hard as he could. He's not able to get him here.
Because even if he gets Brad in a takedown and Brad escapes, that's 8.
Exactly.
That'd be a tough way to lose all those points on an escape, wouldn't it, Tom? I don't know.
Now, actually, what happens, what I meant when major is he has to have 8 points over his opponent.
8 points over
his opponent.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
That's my fault.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah.
No,
so,
he
needs, if Brad can get another 3 points here, he's got the major.
Okay, all right. That's not going to happen right now. But we're going to pick up the 3 and we're going to tie up this thing after 4.
Oh, exactly. And again, we have some strong, powerful wrestlers coming up next,
Yep.
That's the one thing that this team has that we haven't had in years is we have no holes in this team. We are strong throughout.
Top to
Every
bottom.
Single wrestler is the hardest wrestler you're going to find.
Nice. All right, there's a good look at Brad Helmkamp. So Farmington won the first two matches, and then Simsbury's won the next two. We got another good buddy of mine here. We got Christian Kylide, all-conference, all-state football player, center. 6'4", 275, he's a beast. What's the weight class, unlimited?
Oh, it goes to 285, that's as big as you can be.
That's as big as you can be.
But last year, he was also an All-American wrestler.
Wow.
Yes. He's been wrestling for 2 years, but he's a strong, strong wrestler,
He wants to play football in college, but I heard that there are some schools would love to have him wrestle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. He's a good athletic heavyweight, which is really hard to find, Athletic heavyweights aren't something you're just going to find. A lot of times, a lot of teams, you'll just find a lot of heavyweights that really, really aren't that powerful. They're just so big they can use their weight. Christian is just, he's so athletic. He's deceptively athletic. He's strong. He's fast. Good motion. Doesn't get tired easily. And, wrestling teams in college love that. They want that.
Sure. What's so funny about him? And, folks, you're watching this big, huge guy. Great football player. He was a good hoop player until he gave it up. But he's one of the nicest, most gentle personalities you'll ever
meet. He's just a great guy.
He's a sweetheart. But he can flip the switch
here.
And when they snap that football, he hammers people.
It's that killer instinct, And that's what you need for just really any sports.
But
he's
a nice kid off the field and the mat. And that's really, really cool.
Yeah, you need to have those two. You need to have you in your personality and you out on an athletic competition. And again, Christian just one of those perfect examples of just such awesome, great guy off the mat and just a great powerhouse athletic wrestler or competitor, really, on the mat.
And we got a stalemate here, Brick. We got 20 seconds left in the first period at 0-0.
You'll see this a lot with heavyweight matches.
I bet.
And a lot of times with heavyweights, you won't see a lot of shot, like the leg shots that you saw.
Sure.
Because, again, that weight on top of you, a wrestler of similar size, you don't want that weight on top of you. You're going to be looking for drags and trying to drag your – see, like you saw right there, trying to drag your opponent down to the ground.
Spence, while we have a second here, just tell us real quick, if you could, what these wristbands on the referee differentiate.
Now, the wristbands differentiate the different wrestlers. Again, green is home for us. Red is away for Farmington.
Scoring.
Yeah. So, yeah. So when you see a hand go with points there, he keeps the hand that the team, you know.
Yeah.
So if it's green, 2 points, that means Simsbury's got 2 points.
Sure. Okay, thank you. Okay, I thought there was more to it than that. That's pretty easy.
Yep. Good peel off.
Oh my goodness. Come on, K. Let's go, big K. Mm-hmm.
He's in good position here. He's got that one leg up. He's got, and he's got his one.
Oh, good. From an escape.
Yep, he's got that one escape. He's got it.
Good.
And again, especially with heavyweight wrestlers, a lot of times when you set up on the bottom like that, it is really difficult to escape because the wrestler puts so much weight on you. And for a heavyweight wrestler to escape, you know, it's not the easiest thing Christian was able to get because of his athleticism.
This kid hits a golf ball a ton. He was a great baseball player, great hoop player. Then he switches to wrestling, but he always played football all his career. And his dad, Lon, always helped coach and stuff. And his mom's a sweetheart. Great family. Another great Simsbury family.
Oh, yeah. You know, and that's the thing is he's just so accomplished in so many sports. You know, he's just such a great competitor throw and throw. We're about 35 seconds left in this second period. One escape point again with heavyweight matches. It's usually a low-scoring match.
One zip only, Spence.
Mm-hmm. Since they're a wrestler. Chooses down. Christian's good, keeping his weight on top of him.
One zip only, Spence. Yep. 2 minutes, minute 30, 50 seconds to go.
Farmington's able to get that escape, and now we have a tied match. It really counts. Who's really pushing the offense here? You see a lot of that in heavyweight, too. They're just stopping. They don't want to touch each other. Both of them just want to kind of get their breath for about 5 seconds.
Wow.
Christian's got to really be pushing for that takedown right now, trying to drag his opponent down.
1-1, folks. Minute 11. Wow. I really want this win for Christian. Let's go, CK. What do you say, kid?
And a minute left here.
Let's go, CK. Here you go, CK.
So you see a lot of hand firing there. They're trying to pretty much pull the head down a little bit farther to try to go for a front headlock right there. I think that's what both opponents are trying to find on each other.
My head's tingling right now. It's just because I love this kid, you know? I just would love to see it.
Get a win on such a big night.
I would. You know, it's okay either way, but
yeah.
I'd like to see it. 27 seconds. Spencer's are overtime.
There will be overtime. It looks like we're probably going to go into overtime. Smart. Again, he got brought down, but he turned right back around to his opponent and stood up before any points they were able to give him.
You can't run out of bounds, can you?
No, running out of bounds is considered fleeing the mat.
18 seconds, Spencer. We don't want anything crazy to happen here.
Oh, no. There's probably a really good chance, especially with heavyweights, this is going to go into triple overtime.
three extra periods?
There's a good chance we're going to be seeing that here
2 minutes each? Oh, no. 2 seconds. That's it.
Oh, he's not able to get it.
Who was that close for? Yeah.
Farmington?
A potential pointer? Was that
what?
Who that was in the better position?
That was Simsbury. Simsbury okay. should have gotten that too.
We
but
were
again,
close.
it's deciding on the.
Well, maybe really. 5 more seconds we might have, huh?
One more second we would have gotten it. It was that close.
Okay.
But again, now we got 1 minute left here.
It's not
1 minute in overtime. This is sudden death.
Oh man.
The first overtime in wrestling is sudden death. The second one isn't, the third one is.
Wow, I don't know if I like that.
Again, with heavyweights, there's a good chance if it goes into overtime, it's gonna go all the way.
I'm glad my kids played basketball. This is really stressful.
All right.
Jeez. 23 seconds left in sudden death overtime.
Again, it's a good
1-1. Eight seconds.
Yeah, it looks like we might be going into double overtime here and possibly from there triple overtime.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Wasn't able to get it.
Two times.
Reminiscent of the last.
Farmington saved by the bell twice.
Yep.
What's going on? Coach Goody wants to know. Get in on Coach Goodwin, Russ.
And talking to the ref right here.
Let's check this out. There's a good look at Ernie Goodwin. Leader of these Trojan grapplers. All right. I like his style.
Yeah. Goodwin has been, he knows how to talk to refs. He always has. I always remember that. He's very smart, I've seen way too many coaches go out there screaming at refs.
Ernie's
they're not going to get any favors that way.
Course,
you go out there and you talk to him like another person.
Of course.
All right. See, this isn't sudden death right here. Pretty much you just have to stay smart.
Wow. Christian, was that an escape?
That was an escape, but because this isn't sudden death, Christian will also have another 30 seconds to try for himself.
30 seconds after this extenuation?
Yes, after this 30 seconds, he'll have his own chance.
Oh, cool. That doggone escape.
Right. He's now got 30 seconds to try to escape here. He escapes to go into triple overtime.
There's no such thing as letting yourself get maybe in a situation where you can't escape, is there?
What?
Is there any way you can get yourself into a situation that gives you an opportunity to escape?
Yep, right.
Like right now.
He's got it. He might get it. He just needs to kick out his leg. All right, he's still got plenty of time here. He's got 20 seconds here. He wasted 10 there, but again, full 20. You know, if you hit escape hard enough, you can get out in 5 seconds. Sooner than that, really.
I wonder how his mother, Ann, feels right now watching her son out there. That must be tough.
What's he got to do? He's got to push out. He's got his one.
Yeah.
We might be going to triple overtime.
Yeah.
Good chance.
Yeah, Christian.
He's got to just stay smart here for these last 10 seconds.
Wow. 3 seconds. 2. All right. So what is it now?
And since because we had the first choice. Pretty much how it goes every other for choices about up or down. Now we get the choice. Now how it works here is we have 30 seconds.
Okay.
Now, 30 seconds, we are on bottom. If we escape, we win. If he holds us down, they win. So he has 30 seconds to escape.
Oh my goodness.
He's able to get it.
We won?
He's able to get it.
Yeah! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo!
A big win in heavyweight.
Yeah.
Put Simsbury in the lead.
Yeah, CK. That's big.
It's all about momentum.
Yeah, CK. Let's get them in with the senior, Ernie and senior captain Christian Kyle. Parents Ann and Lon. Congratulations,
folks.
That's
a hard, well-fought match right there.
All right, here comes another one of my favorites, too.
Then we
another
got our sophomore
great baseball
right here at 106.
Player, Vinny Palmera.
Oh, yeah.
Love him. He played on my son's Babe Ruth team this year. Great little baseball player, too. All right, we won.
Vinny's been having an amazing year. He's our 106 pounder. He's got that single, being smart with it.
So Simsbury lost the first two, Spencer. They've won the next three in a row to take a 9-6 lead. Mm-hmm. Here comes Vinny Palmieri.
Oh, that was a beautiful ankle pick.
Ooh, we got two there?
Yep. He's a beautiful low ankle pick.
Nice,
right there.
Vin.
Stayed on one knee, sucked in that ankle perfectly. Again, for a sophomore, his technique is impeccable. I mean, this is the type of technique you see, I mean, a freshman in college. I mean, this kid's got great technique. He's strong. He's pinpoint. He knows exactly where to grab at the right time.
He's a gamer is what he is. Oh, he's a gamer.
Oh,
in baseball, he's in Little League, he was the best 60 pounds I've ever seen.
Oh, yeah. He's a hard worker. And, again, in the offseason, he works on his technique. Because, you know, at this weight class, that's what it's all about. You're not going to strengthen out a guy at 106.
Oh, go, man.
It's all about technique. And he's got one of the best techniques.
I'm sorry, what's that weight class, Spence?
106.
When he was 12 years old, he threw hard as I have ever seen anyone who weighed 75 pounds.
Oh, yeah.
And my vision is of him, Spencer, on the mound. Mm-hmm. 4'8", 70 pounds, throwing smoke, pulling seeds out of his back pocket and putting it in his mouth every other pitch. It was great. I'm like, who is this kid? I never had him before. I instantly fell in love with the kid.
Right, he's in a good position here. Looks like he's trying to go for a Turk. Yep, he's going to get it.
Ooh.
Scoring points. That's all he's doing right now.
Wow.
Wasn't able to get it there. Needs to hold the Turk a little bit longer there.
He got
it? Oh, no, actually he did. Never mind.
He got juice.
Yep, and look, he might be able to get him again. He's already been called for two of them.
Vin might go for the skunk for us.
Yep, he's so good at his Turks, which Turks, they put your opponent to the back, but they're not pinning combination. They're there to get points, and he's so good at his tilts. You know, he knows where to put him at the right time.
I got him by about 90 pounds, and he could probably throw me and pin me in about 10 seconds.
Oh, he's a strong 106, so that really helps too. See?
Look at him.
Strong 106.
Yeah, Vin. Would it be Vin? Wow, I'm sorry, folks. I'm yelling in the mic here. I'll try to move it down a little bit. I saw Adam adjusting his headphones after I screamed a couple times. He's trying to turn the volume down. There's no volume on those, Adam.
Oh, he's got a good move here. Here, he's got a chicken wing, but he ran out of time.
What's the chicken wing, Greg? When you pull one in? You pull an arm in?
Never mind. I didn't miscall that. That was actually an arm bar. Now,
what
arm
is a
bar.
Chicken wing?
A chicken wing is actually when you bring the arm back over your back. It's kind of like how you see in films where like an officer kind of pulls the arm up over the back. Same sort of move.
I've not seen it in a film, but my older brother used to do it to me daily.
Oh, beautiful switch out of a Merkel. Well done. That was beautiful. The Farmington wrestler tried a specialty move, a Merkel there on him. But again, because Vinny loves the train technique, he knew exactly what to do. Rolled right out of it.
Wow. Look at Vin. Look at Vin. Who is that over there?
It's one of the team photographers. Rolled right into him.
Vin knows right where the camera is.
All right, another 2 points, and he's got that major. That's what he needs to try to get here. Or if he can, he really wants to try to go for that pin. Definitely put that lead out there. He's got a ball and chain tilt right there. He's got it perfect right there. He just has to keep cranking it. Farmington wrestler doesn't want
keep
any
cranking it.
Wasn't able to get it, though. That's a problem with tilts a lot of times. Is the second you bring them over in a tilt, is that they start to wiggle out of it. Now you need to try to get your tightness on that.
Was that an escape?
What?
No escape.
That was not an escape.
Wow, this is great. Vin needs two more points, and we got a minute 20 left in the second period.
He's got plenty of time.
What happened, man?
Well, what happened is a caution. A lot of times, if you accidentally go too early, kind of like, you know, football, false start. Except you don't lose, you know, you don't lose as much as you do in football. You just get a caution. If I think you have three cautions in a row, it's a point.
Yeah, Vin. Work him, Vin.
Smart wrestling. Got that Turk again. Trying to get those back points.
Vin, just a sophomore. Trojans. Uh-oh.
Wasn't able to get any there. He needs two more. He's got a minute left.
In the second period.
Oh, yep. Looks like he's going for a power half there. Switched off back into the Turk.
Wow.
Or a tilt. Sorry, my fault. Tilt.
We wouldn't know, Spence.
Oh, a little bit high right there. He's staying smart. Ooh. Again,
Smart wrestling from the Simsbury wrestler. Keeps rolling on through it.
You know what's incredible with Vin is he gets the guy in so many predicaments, but the guy doesn't get any escapes.
Exactly. He's staying tight to his opponent. Even when he's not in the greatest position, he stays tight. He keeps his weight on his opponent like he did right there.
Yep.
Top, strong on top.
Vin, you beast.
Oh, looks like he was able to get those 2 points. He's now in a major. He needs to stay safe here. No escapes from the Farmington wrestler.
Eight zip.
Yep, 8-zip right now.
Oh, the skunk happens after the clock stops.
Yes.
Okay. Wow.
He's in a smart position. Again, 21 seconds. He wants to just keep his opponent tight down to the ground. Try to get those four here.
Wow. Vinny's working hard. He looks getting tired. He's leaving it all
on
the
mat. Definitely, he cuts a lot of weight to get down to his weight class.
He's
naturally probably around at 115.
Wow.
He makes the big cut for his team.
Jeez.
Again, that's a big part of wrestling, is making those big cuts for your teammates right here.
Unbelievable.
Oh, yeah. So there's a good chance in the upcoming season he's going to go up to the next weight class.
He's looking close, Spence, to a pin, isn't he?
He's trying to turn him, but again, he's just staying smart here. He's able to get us 4 points here.
Okay, so we got 8-zip after 2 periods. Vinny Palmaro, 106-pound sophomore, trying to win the 4th consecutive match for Goodwin, Coach Goodwin and his Trojans.
Yep, all right, we're in the third now.
Hall, number 3 in the state. Simsbury, number 2, both undefeated. This is stuff that you see in Iowa, not Connecticut.
Oh, yeah, now this is just good old-fashioned wrestling in here. You have two teams that are hungry. They want that. They want that undefeated record. They want that title. They're willing to do whatever they can to get it.
There's 1,000 people or more here, too, tonight, Brent.
Oh, yeah, they have packed this place in. All right, Vinny's staying smart here. He's in a good position.
So Danbury's number 1 in the
state? Danbury's number 1.
Yeah.
Now, what happened right there is Vinny made a little bit of a mistake right there. He figure four locked over the head. That's a really dangerous thing to put. You can't be doing that.
Yep.
He's got to do is try to suck that leg back out. Yep, he's in not exactly the greatest position. But see, he's a strong athlete. And it happened right there.
He got to his stomach.
Yep.
Picked up 2 for Farmington. The lead's 8-3.
Yep. Oh,
a minute 19.
But he's so active on the ground, you know.
He's just so willing to keep moving.
Yep.
He's so strong.
He's willing to just keep moving down there. All right, he's got a minute 15.
His body fat must be about 3%. He's strong, is that right?
He's 3 points out from that. Good little move right there. Oh, wait.
Oh, he got hurt. He landed on his head. Wow.
Again, that's not to blame on anyone right there.
Of course.
Yeah.
This Farmington wrestler has been fighting real hard against Vin. I give these guys so much credit. It's unbelievable. These guys are just so tough. Oh, what a sport. This is really exciting. Wow.
Not sure. Guessing maybe. I guess a concussion, you know. I'm no doctor, I don't want to say, but again, he landed hard in his head right there.
Well, that's the first thing.
Exactly, that's what everyone fears, you know.
The first thing they're going to check on. We got the trainer, Chris, the Simsbury trainer right out there. He works all the sporting events with Emmy Lou McLean. She was here last night for the hoop game. Simsbury beat number 9, New Britain, in a great game. Simsbury is a top 20 team in the state.
That's great. That's great to hear.
Yeah.
All right. We'll figure out the decision in another minute here.
What would they do, Spence? They don't sub out a wrestler. No.
Well, what would happen?
He's injured.
Yeah. They're probably.
And what's the points? Just 3 points to the.
It actually, my belief, and I mean, I might be off on this for some reason. I believe that it's 6 points for an injury. I don't want to say yes or no to that
right now.
Because I haven't seen this in so many, you know, it's been a long time since I've seen this.
There's the Farmington coach really doing a nice job with his wrestler.
Oh, exactly.
Asking a series of questions.
He's compassionate about his wrestling.
All these coaches are trained.
All right, looks like we might actually go back into the mat.
Good for him. Yep. Let's hear a nice round of applause for that Farmington Indian wrestler.
All right.
Their coach did a nice job. I like him. I like the style of these guys. wants to talk to the doctor. Thank
you
for coming
out. Vinny needs to try to get one more takedown here. Yep, he's got the single. He's got to be smart. Got that double. Works up.
11-3.
He's in good
Spencer.
Position.
Oh, a pin?
Not so much for a pin. He might be able to just get some points. You got two additional points right
there. That's 12. Yep. That's 13-3, Spence.
Exactly. He's now 10 up right now. He's in a great position. He has a two-point leeway now.
Okay. Now,
what Vinny's not realizing right here that he's having a little trouble here is that his Farmington opponent's shoulder blades are outside of outside of the circle. You can't call back points or get a pin outside the circle.
I see. So you don't give up there, though, right? You don't let it up.
It appears right here that we might have a cramp, I'm going to assume.
On Vin?
Yep. Again, you know, that weight cut can sometimes do it.
That weight class?
Mm-hmm. That weight cut. Like the cut that he makes to get down to that weight class a lot of times. You know, he's usually very hydrated and so on and such forth. But sometimes, you know, if you don't fully hydrate, if you don't do everything you can to hydrate.
Up.
Yeah.
Spencer, you're not saying that Vin might have weighed 112 or 111 like 4 or 5 days
ago. Oh, no. I'd say he's probably weighed in probably like 108.
So okay.
You know what? No, he weighs in now 106. There's a 108. There's a 2-pound allowance after Christmas.
Yeah. Okay.
So he probably walked around like 110. He cut like 2 pounds.
Okay.
Yeah. But again, it's just one of those things where a lot of times if a wrestler right after weigh-ins isn't vigilant about getting Gatorades and waters into him, a lot of times it can happen.
With 36 seconds left, Vinny Palmaro fighting his heart out. Farmington wrestler giving him a great battle. 13-3. This could be a big one for the Trojans.
Another 4 points.
Wow.
Just smart motion right there from both wrestlers. You know, Farmington wrestler trying to stay in bounds. Vinny just keeping him in a good position.
Vinny's fighting it off right now, Brick. He's hurting.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, nice, Vin.
Good motion right there. You know, brought him right down.
Just
to
hold
that.
Him there, Vin, right? Just hold him.
Just stay
strong. 10 seconds.
Stay strong. Stay back.
Even if he escapes, it doesn't matter.
Escape. He's in a little bit of a dangerous position
here. He is. 2 seconds.
No, not enough time for Farmington.
Yeah, Vinny Palmaro.
Able to get those Woo-hoo! 4 points.
He really fought hard. Way to go, VP.
Hard fought match right there. And you know what? I'll give it to the Farmington wrestler to you. Near the end, really started to push on, was injured there for a little bit, and then came back strong. But again, Simsbury there gave everything it could at the very end.
So we picked up 6 there.
No, we picked up 4 on that one.
4?
Yep.
That's right. I'm sorry.
Major,
good. Thank you. Good. Wow, that's 4 in a row, Brett.
Oh, yeah. All right, Augie Savarese at 113 here.
Thank you. Spencer, you know all these guys' weight class because they stay there for the whole season?
Yeah, they usually stay there the whole season. Once in a while when that 2-pound allowance happens after Christmas, some kids might drop down a weight class. But for the most part, what they start at, they're gonna end
What's at. What's a 2-pound allowance?
The 2-pound allowance is that after Christmas, the wrestler is allowed an additional 2 pounds from his own weight class. So 145 technically becomes 147.
He can wrestle at 147 if he wants.
Yeah, well, at this weight class, he can wrestle at 115, you know?
Yeah, like that's right. Plus right. 2. Okay, yep.
All right, so now score 2-1. Farmington is up right here. Farmington wrestler is a strong wrestler. And again, Simsbury is a hard-working wrestler. Augie Savarese, been wrestling 4 years. Actually, 4 years only high school. He wrestled several years youth wrestling. You know, he's a hard-working wrestler.
What year is he, Spencer?
He is currently a senior.
Nice.
He's got to watch his ankles right here. He's got to stay safe. See how he's not letting his legs touch? See, he's smart.
Oh, boy.
Oh, he's holding on to the ankle.
What a move. Coach Kenny Parra shouting some instructions to his wrestler.
All right, what Augie wants to do here is let go of the leg. He's in a dangerous position.
Wow.
Smart, though, by the Simsbury wrestler. Yep. A lot of times, if you know you're in a dangerous situation, just let go and switch off to your stomach.
Picked up 4 to the Indians on that one, Spencer.
All right, he's tempting the switch right there. A little out of position. He wants to try to work his way back into a base. What he wants to do is try to get his wrist back here. He's staying smart. He's not letting. Now, Farmington wrestler was attempting a chicken wing right there. He kept his arm in tight, didn't allow it.
August Savarese, senior, 113 class for the Trojans.
All right.
So we're into the second period, 4-1 Farmington lead here.
Oh, Augie got a single right there.
Oh, what a roll.
A little bit of a funk move right there.
Goes to 6-1 Farmington.
Augie's got to stay smart here. Yep. Oh, he might be able to get a switch. Ah. He needs to try to throw his hips up over. No, he's out of position now. He's got to try to hold on to that leg, see if he can get a stalemate here. He should not have let go of the leg, but oh, he's staying smart. He's in a little bit of a dangerous position right now. Nope. Needs to avoid letting that arm go up. Farmington wrestler has clearly got a lot of technical knowledge. He's switching off the moves. Again, the Simsbury wrestler is tenacious, not allowing anything to happen. You got a stalemate there. 58 seconds left in the second.
6-1 Farmington. Simsbury's got a 13-6 lead after five wrestlers. This is number six for the evening. They started at the 170 weight class and went up, working back down.
All right, Augie's got good motion. Yep, he's able to get that escape. Now he wants to stay strong here, keep a good base.
A little chess match going on out there right now.
Exactly, both wrestlers sizing each other up, trying to find holes and pockets.
They both have very similar body styles.
Exactly.
Augie's pretty slender.
Yep.
He's a slender 115. Maybe an inch taller than his opponent, inch or two taller.
Short time is third period. Gotta stay smart. Yep, hold on to that arm. Oh, he's able to get the two at the end there, though.
Two more for Farmington to end the second period.
All right, Simsbury has chosen down right here. Going to try to get that escape point. Definitely try to make sure the that major stays far away.
Right. That's very important right now, isn't it?
A little bit of a dangerous. Up. Good motion right there from both wrestlers, knowing what their opponent's looking for. Right. We got about a minute 45 left in this third period. Right. Oh, smart. Yep, he's staying big right there. He's not allowing for any real moves to get in there. He's got to watch himself right here. He's not in danger of getting pinned right here. Gave up some points right there, but again, the major is better than getting pinned right here.
Absolutely.
He needs to get his head up off the mat here, but he's in good position. He's wrestling smart. All right, I mean, this is nothing worse for a wrestler than this, you know, getting stuck in the bottom, getting beaten up. But again, Augie's a smart, strong wrestler. He's willing to fight.
Jeez. What's with the forearm smack on the top of the head there?
Well, he's trying to confuse the opponent, trying to not let him know where he's going with it. You know
I'm
what I mean?
Sure. I'm not sure I believe that. He may have been trying to make us think he was doing that as he popped him two or three times.
Got about 24 seconds right here. He has the major right now.
Augie, a four-year wrestler. He plans on studying political science and international relations in college.
Got 19 seconds left here.
His parents, Wendy and August Severis, proudly watching
here.
Augie battle. 11-2.
I mean, hard match for Augie right here. This is a good kid wrestling.
Yeah.
But, you know, he stays strong. He doesn't allow any extra points to be taken here.
Nice. All right.
You know, that happens. You know, when you have an opponent that
they were
chances are that you're going to get beat, you know, do what you can to avoid from losing any more points. It was a strong match for Augie. He was a tough kid. He stayed strong throughout. You know, and he saved some points for his team. That's what really matters.
Oh, here's my man right here, Ben Durst.
Good old Ben Durst.
Oh, man.
I remember when he was a freshman when I was a senior. Can't believe how old he is now.
Little tidbit Coach Goodwin gave me. Ben Durst has 135 wins. He's 11 away from tying the all-time Simsbury wins leader, Joey Martin, who had 146.
He is that close. He is that good of a wrestler. And again,
this kid's an All-American, All-State, and he's a National Honor Society student.
He's a hell of a wrestler, too.
What weight class, Spence?
This is 119. 120, actually. Sorry, I'm thinking the old school weight classes. It's 120.
Thank you. This guy is another one of my major league favorites.
He's a hard wrestler. You know, he's works so hard in the off season.
129, you said.
Oh, no, 120.
120, I'm sorry. Yep. I bet he works hard.
I mean, he's been wrestling. He's been wrestling youth wrestling for years, off season. You know,
yep.
He focused so much on wrestling. He wants to be so good at wrestling.
That's great. And he's a National Honor Society student. His QM's over 4-0.
Yeah.
He's picking colleges. They're not picking him.
Exactly.
He's got three brothers, two brothers, Matt and Tommy. Mm-hmm. Three boys. Yeah, B. His mother, Jenny, his dad, Matt, two of the nicest people you ever want to meet.
Oh, yeah. Great family.
Great family.
Great upbringing, you know. Oh,
love my dad.
He had all the support in the world for the sport, too, which helps. And again, you know, it shows, you know.
Well, his dad's strong. His dad was a wrestler. His dad's an unbelievably strong guy. All right, 4-1.
Oh, looks like he might get the cradle here. He has plenty. Wasn't able to get it.
Let's go,
lost
Betty.
The hands.
But when Coach Goody said he needs 11 more wins to tie the record, are there 11 more opportunities left in a year?
There is this one right here. Now, the problem is that there's a good chance that the tournament this weekend will be canceled because of the snow. That makes it a lot tougher to try to get those wins.
They won't reschedule that tournament?
The tournament itself is kind of it's a postseason tournament, but the postseason is considered to start the tournament after. It's kind of almost like a extra tournament.
Jeez.
So there's a really good chance it might get canceled.
Okay.
Again, it's a little bit tougher, but again, he'll be in the top five all-time wrestlers in Simsbury history, you know, of wins.
What's he trying to do, Brick?
Now right here, he's kind of in a weird position right here.
He got up though.
Yeah. It looked like he was maybe trying to go for a cradle, wasn't able to get it. Again, Ben, smart position right here.
Wow.
Yep. Beautiful wrestling right there.
Yeah, Dursty!
Got in a high base and just shucked him off the top of him.
Oh, yeah. BD. There's the student section. Breaks out in the too quick. Let's go, Ben. Ben, one of the captains.
Yep. A lot of times, if you feel like you're not getting anything out of your opponent, you just let him back up and try to go for shots.
Yep.
Oh, beautiful reshot right there from Simsbury.
Wow.
Just stayed active the entire time. Beautiful double leg drive.
1 minute left in the second period.
right now. Looks like he's trying to push for the major. Yeah, he's got plenty of time to try to go for it. He's going to let him up and try to continuously take him down and try to get that major.
No surprise Ben wants to be an engineer. Going to study engineering at the next level. Ooh. Wow. Wow.
See, that's beautiful.
Jeez, they're quick.
What?
They're quick. Oh, man.
That's a little bit of a dangerous,
got two there.
A little bit of a dangerous situation right there.
24 seconds left. The score is 8-5. 24 seconds in the second period.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep. Bringing him back into the center. 10 seconds left for Ben to try to get an extra escape point here.
It'd be nice to pick up one and get that spread to 4 points.
Exactly. So you have more time to work. And that wasn't able to get it. See, it looked like he was trying to go for a standing switch there. We're going into the third now.
8-5, Ben Durst lead. 120 pounds, senior captain, team leader. Come on, BD. You work, kid.
Beautiful double leg right there. Very strong, powerful double leg.
Wow. Picked up two, Brick. Double up that lead 10-5 with a minute 14. I like it.
Got about three more points he's going to try to get here.
Can he get a major?
He needs, three more points to try to get that major right now.
Wow. Got an escape there for Farmington wrestler. 10-6. Just under a minute left in this match.
He needs about three more takedowns to try to get it. Because again, he takes him down, and then when he lifts him back up, the other guy gets one more point. He needs three more takedowns. It's a little rough in this amount of time. What he might try to do is take him down, put him right to his back.
Ooh, wow. Adam Razdowski getting you right into the living room, folks. SCTV Channel 95, bringing you the wrestling action here tonight. Coach Goodwin and Coach's para, Goodwin look very relaxed over there with their senior leader right now.
About 15 seconds left in the third here.
And we'll pick up three.
Yeah, we're going to pick up the three right here, as long as we stay smart.
Yes.
Oh.
One last
takedown for the match.
Oh, shoot. Oh, nice try, Ben.
Oh, yep. Looks like we're not going to get anything to end the match here.
But
all right.
Nothing foolish.
Nope. Good match for Durst. Got that win on his senior night. That's always the best. And that puts Simsbury up by 6.
Yes, it does.
All right. And up next, we have one of the two freshman phenoms on the Simsbury team, Keith Penny.
My son Avery's told me about Keith. Wow. Partner, what weight class?
126 pounds.
Thank you. We're heading back up the up the dial.
Oh, he's got the single. He's got it smart.
Vinny Palmera was 106.
He's so strong for a freshman, too. He's got such great wrestler strength, you know? The fact that he was able to just drag his opponent's head down there. You know, again, years and years of youth wrestling training has brought him up to this point.
I heard he's got some serious youth credentials.
Oh, he does.
Since we were with a 16-10 lead after seven wrestlers.
Right, including this match, we have 6 matches left to this match.
We're a little over halfway through. But.
Yep. We're moving. Oh, he's got a good arm bar right there. He's got to keep it strong. A little bit of a tough position to use it right there, and he's near the edge of the mat. Mm-hmm. He's going to try to suck him back in. But a lot of times if you can't something, you just let it go out in the out of bounds and go back into the center.
At that point, is that Farmington wrestler trying to get out?
Yeah, at that point, it's, you know what? They want a fresh start. Yeah. Again, that's just a natural thing you see with wrestlers. Looks like he's going for that arm bar again. Might be 2-on-1, actually. It drags him back down. Again, for a freshman wrestler, he has such a good top lean, which pretty much he's so good at putting his weight on top of his opponent, you know? So good at sapping the energy out.
Does that come from the legs, Brick?
What? Yeah, it comes from just good, strong legs and, you know, knowing where to put your shoulders on top of your opponent.
Yep. Seconds in the first period.
Oh, he's got he's in good position for a half Nelson right there. A short time, though. Keith right there. See, he's got a good hand on the neck right there, but
sure.
Good defense from the Farmington wrestler.
Farmington wrestler looks like he wants to get out of Dodge.
Exactly. Short time is pretty much just going to keep him there. Going into the second. You know, with all that work, you forget that he's only up by 2 right now. It's a 2-0 match.
That's a good point.
But again, you know, he's a strong worker. He's going to continuously work.
Good point. 2-0 after 1. That was a hard-earned 2 for Keith Penny, freshman. 120. 126.
Mm-hmm. All right. Looks like the Farns Russ is trying to get a front headlock. And we might get a stalemate call here soon.
Really? Keith seems kind of buried in there.
He's not in the worst position on earth right now. Mm-hmm. It's not exactly the position he wants to be in, but he's not far away from trying to get that 1 point. There's a good chance.
From the escape.
Yeah.
Good point.
There's a good chance that the ref's going to call this stalemate soon. We'll see. Again, Keith, again, with such knowledge of wrestling, knows where he needs to be at all times there.
Well, the winner of this match wins the CCC
West title, yep.
And that has not been a CCC West title for Simsbury since 2001.
Yep, been a while. All right, and he's able to get his escape point. Drained a lot of time there.
Seconds left in the second period. 3-0. Keith Penny, Trojan grappler, in the lead. What a hard-fought 3. Farmington wrestler, very skilled.
Oh, got a single.
Yeah, Penn.
Plenty of time. Perfect one.
KP, good flip.
Beautiful move there. Oh, trying to keep him in, trying to get those back points.
With the chin, Rick, huh?
Oh, yeah. In that position, it's all right. It's pretty much he's using it as like a lever to try to put him down.
Yeah.
Right, up by 5 right now. Simsbury chooses down.
Okay. Third period. 5-point Simsbury lead.
Right. He's got to keep working to get up. He's trying to get that ankle free right now. Yep. Wrestling smart.
Coach Goodwin,
smart right there.
Coach Goodwin letting his freshman go. Really not giving any intense.
He's in good position right there. He needs to try to get that single out.
Oh, good reverse.
He's in a good position right there.
Wow. Oh, he's trying to flip
him. Oh, yeah, no. He's got a three-quarter Nelson, it looks like, right there. He's trying to bring him over to his back.
Yep. Wow. Coach Goody wanted something there. What
he
wanted?
He wanted the reversal right there.
Okay.
55 seconds. Keith wants to try to get one more takedown and try to get that major here.
Wow.
Oh, beautiful. Right into the single.
That would be unbelievable if he did that.
Oh, beautiful. That is great wrestling IQ right there.
His feet stayed in.
You have great, that's just a great wrestler right there. He slides, he keeps his toes just barely in.
That's like a receiver in football who makes the catch and keeps his toes.
Yep.
That's cool.
That's just great wrestler IQ, knowing exactly where you are and knowing where to keep your feet.
Absolutely. 36 seconds left in this match.
About 30 seconds left here. He just needs to stay strong. Don't allow any points. Short time. 5 seconds left. Keith is just staying strong, not allowing any extra points.
Wow.
Was able
nice
to get that
job.
Major right there.
Woo-hoo!
Able to get four for the team.
That's a big four, Brett.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. That's a big four.
Much needed eight right there.
The freshman delivers the goods. Keith Petty.
Right here. We got our next freshman phenom, Keith Fernandez.
Oh.
Again, another wrestler who's been wrestling in youth for years. His father actually runs the Fisheye Youth Wrestling Club.
Yeah, at Granby.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Wow.
132 pounds,
mm-hmm.
Freshman Keith Fernandez. Eighth Trojan wrestler tonight.
Good motion from both wrestlers, both trying to feel each other, trying to find the pockets and holes that they can go in on. Got caught in a front headlock right there, but smart wrestling from the freshman. Thirty seconds left in this first period. Looks like might be a no score. We'll see. Keith is actually one of those wrestlers I've noticed is that as the match goes on, he gets better and better. He's one of those wrestlers where second period is better than his first, third period is better than his second.
Wow.
He's a very strong wrestler, you know.
Wow.
He's very tenacious, great conditioning.
That's the conditioning's the key.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, nice job by the freshman, Keith Penny.
Good first period.
Keith Fernandez.
That's definitely the hard part is having two freshmen, weight classes right next to each other, both named Keith.
Thank you, absolutely. I fell into the trap. Rick.
Oh, yeah.
0-0 after one. How are you doing?
He's able to get his one escape point there. Good motion from the Farmington wrestler. think both wrestlers realize the skill that each other has. So they're not. They don't want to. They're smart right now. Wrestling's smart.
Too many openings.
Yep. Of course, that's the problem with wrestling. Is if you're gonna take a shot, you're gonna open yourself up.
Sure.
Because you're going after him, you know. A lot of times you'll have that with two guys who are so well skilled. Yeah. Not a lot will happen.
Yeah.
All right, right there. Looks like he has a front headlock on Keith.
You know what I would have loved?
Trying to switch off from the knee.
What I would have loved to know, Spencer, is what class these Farmington wrestlers are. See, like, this could be a senior against a freshman.
Oh, yeah. About 45 seconds left in the second. Oh, smart wrestling. About 30 seconds left here.
What a great feeling it must be, Spencer, when you win your match and you get to sit down like Christian Kylide and Brad Helmkamp.
I will admit,
watch.
Though, such a big match like this, the nerves have to be running through and through because you want that win. You know, the nerves of having your match are over, which are always nice.
You want
you know.
The team win.
But, yeah, those butterflies are still sitting there.
Of course.
For, especially with this one, such a monumental match.
Right. No doubt.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he's got a double right there. Not exactly in the greatest position, but not exactly in the worst either.
Sure.
Ran out of time there.
So that's the end of two. It's only 1-0, Spencer. Farmington. 20-10 overall lead for the Trojans.
All right. Odd choice there. Since they decided not to take bottom right there. Try to get that escape point and tie it up. They're going neutral. Trusting Keith to try to get that those 2 points here. Try to get that takedown. About 1:30 left in this third period, still plenty of time. Only 1 point away.
Wow. Just looking from the body of this Farmington wrestler with the developed muscles.
Yeah.
I'm thinking he's a junior or senior.
Exactly, you know, and that can definitely be a downside of being such a good freshman wrestler. Right. So again, you are so good. But your muscle mass still hasn't caught up to you.
Sure.
You know, you have the skill, the drive, all of that, but then, you know, genetics is the one that's holding you back, which is really rough. But again, you know, especially Keith, you know, he's definitely going to be in a much bigger weight class in the next few years. You can tell he's going to definitely grow into himself.
Yeah.
He's tall, a little lengthy, but, you know, when he gets some muscle on him, he's going to be a force to reckon with.
Does the success of the wrestler change in those situations, Spencer? Could he go to too much of a high weight class where he might be outmatched?
Sometimes you'll have the wrestlers, but again, smart, intelligent wrestlers like Keith, and, you know, his father's behind him, showing him the way, will know to go in the right weight class.
Sure,
I've seen that before. A wrestler will jump up too high of a weight class. He doesn't want to make the big cuts, so he'll just instead choose to go up.
1-0, 27
seconds. 27
seconds. What the tightest match of the day.
Oh, yeah. Keith's got to try to push through. And,
wow.
You know, that's definitely what's holding him back right now is the fact that the other wrestler has so much more musculature. It's stopping his shots, which is rough.
Let's go, big Keith. Here you go, kid.
Yep.
Let's go, Keith. Wow.
About 10 seconds left here is going to be. Looks like we're not going to be able to.
What a match. An escape would have been nice.
Yeah. But you know what? I'm assuming that possibly the Farmington wrestler was a really, really accomplished top wrestler.
Yeah,
so it's better to lose a three than possibly be caught in a situation where you lose more.
Wow, 1-0.
Yeah, it was a tough match. It was. And again, the thing that really held it back was just the fact that the Farmington wrestler had so much upper body strength, it just stopped Keith's shots.
Yep. 1-0. That's incredible.
Oh, yeah. I've seen those matches. Those are the big ones.
Thank you.
Johnny D. Pasquale, senior wrestler.
Senior.
Looking to try to get that win on senior night.
Senior captain John D. Pasquale with his parents Patty and Phil D. Pasquale in the stands. Ooh, watching the
shot. Oh, beautiful single. Looks like he's trying to go for a Turk. He's running outside the mat. Yeah, that'll happen when you're driving. You will drag a guy, accidentally push a guy right out of the mat.
He's trying to get him back.
He's trying to suck him back in. Smart.
That's just great
wrestling.
Johnny D.
That's just smart wrestling. This is a kid that wants a big win for his senior night.
He looks like he's about
to
do it.
Last time he's ever going to wrestle in this gym, he wants a big one.
Oh, he looks tough.
Oh, yeah. He wants it big.
Two zip Simsbury, Johnny D. Wow.
Oh, yeah. Exactly. You know, for these seniors, the last time after 4 years of wrestling in these gyms, so they want it big. They want that big win. They want something to remember it by. See, what he really wants to do is keep trying to drag him closer and closer into the center of the mat, you know? Mm-hmm. It's a little rough working that
right,
far out.
I bet.
Wow. See, right at the edge of the mat right there. Kind of tough to work in that spot right there. Yeah, it looks like he might run out of time. Oh, nope, got about 15 seconds to try to work something.
I'm laughing because three of the players from my son's basketball team just walked by. They don't know anything about wrestling, believe me. Rayon Christie and Walter White and Tomashi Adams just walked by, and they went up to the student section. I think that's fantastic.
Oh, yeah, you know.
The hoop team just finished practice.
The fact that they're coming in here and supporting
us.
Yeah,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah, it's really, it was just funny to see them watch. Rayon. All right.
Brought him back down, didn't allow any points. Right there, that's the chicken wing right there.
That was the chicken,
that was chicken wing.
That was the chicken.
That's the fun one.
Yeah, yeah. Johnny D still with that two-point lead after two. No, going into two. I'm sorry, just after one.
Johnny's in the throwing position right now. Farmington wrestler attempts it.
Oh!
Able to get the two.
Ties it up.
A good motion right there by Farmington wrestler.
That was a nice move, Spencer.
Yep.
All right, Johnny's a little upset about that. You can see him.
Yep.
Roz got you right in on that. You can see the look on his head. So we got 122 in the second quarter, second period.
Oh, yeah.
John D. Pasquale, another young student that wants to go study engineering in college.
Yep. Oh, beautiful.
And what was
the one?
We got one?
I'm not even sure what that move was. He pretty much ran out, stopped, ducked under. It almost kind of looked like switching in like a football move, just kind of stopping and juking around.
Wow.
It was a beautiful move. Wasn't able to get the takedown, was able to get the escape point.
Yeah, and takes the lead back. 3-1, 3-2. Johnny D. Pasquale.
Mm-hmm. 50 seconds in the second period.
The 142 weight class.
What? This is the 138.
38.
The next one from here is 45, then 52, then 60 is our last match of the night.
Is that Eddie Novak, the last match of the night?
Yep, last match of the night is Eddie Novak.
Wow, good guy to have as your last match. Another one of my favorites, Eddie Novak.
Oh, he's got that single, short time. Try to get his two, might be a little tough. Ran out of time.
All right, that's the end of two periods. Wow, another tight one, Spence.
This is a tight one.
This is after the Fernandez. 1-0. Seven-point lead for the Trojans, 20-13. This is match 10.
All right, he's trying to push up out. All right, smart motion from the Simsbury wrestler. All right, see, he's squaring himself up with the Farmington wrestler. It's a smart move right there. He's going to try to stand up. It's right at the very edge of the mat.
Wow. Minute 20 left. Only a one-point Farmington lead. This very tight match. And Spencer, this could be a possible swing match here.
Possibly. We have, including this one, four matches left tonight. Oh, and he's able to get a two right there.
Wow, really?
Great little move right there.
All right.
All right, we got a minute three left.
Simsbury goes up 6-2. Johnny DePasquale really fighting hard here.
Oh, yeah. Up by four, gave himself a little bit more of a leeway, but got to wrestle smart.
Whoa!
Right there, that's called a Granby roll. It's a good move, but you can only really pull it once in a match, and you have to pull it really, really quick.
Wow, on
the
head. Pretty much
a shock and awe
move.
Yeah, the shock and awe move.
Wow. All right, so we got 50 seconds left, 6-2.
Yep.
Johnny DePasquale lead. The Farmington coach really shouting some instructions to his wrestler. Mm-hmm.
25 seconds left in the third here.
138 pounds.
Yep, going over the head. He's trying to get out.
A chicken wing.
He's got a chicken wing right there. He's trying to get it. No, yep, he might have. No, no.
Oh.
He's got to try to throw it hard here. He's got to try to get in a good position. He might still be able to try to get something here. Short time. He might just be trying to hold him. 2 seconds left here.
Really no difference in the results if that went 6-4, is it?
What?
It wouldn't
have been. No,
no, no. Or 8-2, it wouldn't matter either.
No. You would need an additional 4 points.
Right.
All right.
All right.
Another win for Simsbury. Three more matches left.
Wow.
It's still as close as you can possibly be.
Nice job by Johnny DePasquale.
No runaway wins here. No.
Great match.
Oh, yeah.
For the senior.
It's just a great night of wrestling.
It
I can say
sure
that much.
Is. Who do you got here, Spence?
You got Austin Weiss right
here.
Oh yeah.
Oh, what another one of my old baseball guys. Wow. Went to high school with his dad, Bill. His mom, Renee. Oh, that's great. He's a junior.
A senior.
He's a senior.
4 years. This is his first varsity year.
Yep.
He had a great, beautiful funk move right there. That was almost freestyle, I'd say.
What's Austin weigh now?
Austin weighs in at 145.
Wow.
You know, this past year he went to off-season wrestling. He really worked so hard.
He's really showing
this year. Oh, yeah. He's a strong, tough wrestler. Worked so hard this past year to get on this varsity lineup.
You should have seen him run the base pass. He was lightning. He's so fast. His dad, a 1977 Simsbury graduate, Bill Weiss.
If Austin is able to get this win here, if my math is correct and he's able to get the win here,
Wow.
The match is out of Farmington's hands. If he can get only 3 points here, all he needs is 3 points for the win. And there's no way for Farmington to be able to catch back up in the last two matches.
Spencer, in golf we call that dormy. They're dormy.
So close to one of the biggest victories in Simsbury history.
Wow. So exciting. This is great to be here.
See, and that was just great defense from the Simsbury wrestler. You know, I think it was a good shot from the Farmington wrestler. The Simsbury is good at putting, you know, getting their hips into him, letting the legs away, and pushing the cross face.
Jeez. Has Austin been wrestling 4 years? I don't think so. That's amazing. 4 years. Going to study some business in college. Good decision, AW. Wow. Wow.
Good. Got a good sprawl. A little bit of a dangerous position there. Yep. Front Smith is able to grab the ankle and turn his leg right there.
You trying to get out, Brick?
Right there?
No.
Yep.
Was trying to get out?
Yeah. Well, again, short time, made it a little difficult.
So that's the end of the first period, 2-0, Farmington. Ross, how's the neck doing? All right? Yeah. Back. What I do for hoop, I bring the tripod here, and that way the guy, you can sit.
Usually I just need to stretch the calves. Or
yeah.
But I'm good.
Yeah.
Good motion by Weiss. He's got to try to push back up into his base right now. Try to get that arm free. All right. This is the second period right here.
Yeah. 2-0. Farmington. Simsbury lead.
Oh, good motion from Simsbury, so trying to get that escape. Smart wrestling. Might get stuck here in a chicken wing. He's staying strong, not allowing that arm to go back. He's in a good position. Not exactly a good position, but better position than he was almost just stuck in.
Mm. Ooh. Good roll.
Dangerous move right there.
It was. Farmington fans like what they see. Is he going for a spin? The pin, isn't he, Brick?
Yep, he's going for it.
Come on, Weiss.
Weiss is in dangerous position.
Oh, my. Oh, he got up.
Yep. He's able to break up through. He's got to keep pushing up.
Wow.
Yep.
What a fight by Austin Weiss.
Good hard fight there at the end. Woo-hoo-hoo!
Yeah, Austin. Nice job. That was close.
Oh, yeah. That was dangerous.
Wow.
That was the definition of dangerous.
Oh, that was seconds from him.
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to calm down my heart right now.
How many points would that have been?
That would have been 6 points. That would have been very, mm-hmm. very dangerous.
It's
Simsbury.
A huge swing.
Yeah.
Cut the lead from 10 to 4.
Yeah.
With two matches left. Jeez. Ooh, Austin fighting for dear life. Wow. Coach Goodwin's shining some instructions.
Mm-hmm.
Any idea what you're saying?
I think what he was trying to say is one before two, which means if you're on top and you feel the threat of getting reversed, just let him go. Let him only get one. Don't let him get any more.
I see. Yep. He did say that, Spence. He said one before two.
See, so Weiss sees, all right, I'm in a little bit of a dangerous position. Just let him go.
Right now, if I'm Austin, I don't know wrestling, but I'm thinking I'm playing real defensively.
Yeah,
right
at this point, you just got to be defense.
Without stalling.
Yep.
Maybe even take one stall warning.
Yeah. Maybe, you know what? Even take one stall point at that point. You know what?
Yeah.
Because if he gets the takedown,
yeah,
he gets the major. So even if you give up one stall point, you still avoid that major.
Yeah, and I got to believe it. Like in most sports, a referee doesn't want to dictate the outcome. He's not going to throw points.
Exactly. He's not, yeah. He'll only start calling stalling when it's clear. It's,
right.
You know, when
yep. And the warning might take a while, but I bet the next one comes quicker.
Yes, much quicker. Because you pretty much given a warning that you're stalling. You might, you know, like the first one is, hey, here's letting you know you're stalling. The yeah. second one's like, I already gave you a yeah. warning. You oh, already know you shouldn't be
point.
Doing it. Yeah. All right, minute 11 right here. Since there's just got to be thinking smart defensively.
Oh, nice.
He keeps that single. It's smart. He's got to stay on that
single.
He lost it, though.
Shoot, now it's got 8 points.
Now he's got to try to fight to get up.
For an escape point.
Yep.
And that would be huge.
That would be.
53 seconds left, 8-0.
Yep. But he's also got to watch out for getting pinned. That'd just be just as big, just as huge, but just not in our direction.
Or it could be a 4-point.
Yep.
If he doesn't get an escape, it could be a 4-point swing.
Mm-hmm. All right, he just got called for stalling on bottom right there.
He did?
Yep. At this point, again,
he doesn't want to stall.
Yeah. Well, even at this point, he's trying to avoid that pin. This kid's really good on top.
He's
trying to avoid giving up 6 points.
29
Four
seconds.
4 points is better than six.
Yes, it is. 29 seconds.
Yep.
Farmington fans really
yep.
cheering on their wrestler.
Right. Yep, he's working back up into his base.
Escape, Austin. Go, Austin!
Got about 10 seconds left here.
Ooh.
Might be able to avoid it.
5 seconds. He's hunkered down.
All right. Able to avoid that pin. Brings the match a lot closer than I think we wanted, but keeps it alive. All right.
Senior Austin Weiss, good battle, Austin. Where
as
you
soon
go,
as
Zuri kid.
Gets a win here, this is a decider.
So the lead goes 17-23. I'm sorry, I missed the wrestler's name. Simsbury.
Simsbury is Tyler Stem.
Thank you. ...152-pound battle here.
Mm-hmm.
Another captain for Coach Goodwin, Tyler Stem. 3 years wrestling, first place Frank Chase tournament.
Yeah, he's had a great year this year.
Second place Skip Arden. Plans to study business and entrepreneurial studies.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. I wonder if he walks his yep. Shark Tank.
He's got that single right there. Stem's got a good.
Wow.
He's in good position. Not letting anything up. Oh, no points yet. No points awarded. He stays so strong in that wizard. Such a yes.
His legs
a
are so strong.
Great move right there from the Simsbury wrestler.
Captain Tyler Stem. Second to last match.
There's a very good chance this match will come down to criteria.
What's that mean?
Criteria means that if it's tied, they start looking at who won the most, who pinned the most. They pretty much decide when the match is over. The first criteria is who won the most, and then from there it goes to who got the most pins and so on and so
forth. Wait, but if we win the point total, that's
criteria. Yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah.
only if it's a tie.
If it's a tie, yes, we
wow,
go to a point
does that
criteria.
Happen much?
It's already happened at least once this year.
Wow.
Yep.
That sounds a little discretionary. Is there some wiggle
yep.
room in there?
I don't
know if I liked it. No, okay. Wow, discretionary. Even the term itself leads you to believe there's... Oh!
Oh, a little questionable motion right there.
Yeah, 9 seconds left. 2-point Farmington
yep.
lead there in the first quarter, the first period.
Time! 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 Time!
Time?
Sorry, I shouldn't have yelled that into my
Did
mic.
You call time up?
No, as in the clock ran out and he continued counting.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Sorry.
Might
have yelled that into the mic.
Oh, you don't want to hear what I yell in basketball. Coach Goodwin, right now our leader, talking with the referee, pulling over the Farmington coach for some odd reason.
Pretty much right here, they're talking both on the side.
Can't quite hear what's going on.
Argument between coaches.
Time and they clock issue.
Thank you, Adam. Wow. This match has all the excitement, all the elements. It's getting extremely tense in this gymnasium right now, folks. Number two, number three in the state of Connecticut. Wow. Five zip, Farmington lead. Second period of the second to last match in tonight's epic battle on SCTV.
There's no better way to say it than that, epic.
February 6th, what a battle.
It looked like he was attempting something there where, unsportsmanlike, where he tried to, as Tyler had his hands right there, try to put one knee down to show off to the ref. If you have hands locked there, a lot of times ref will call it unsportsmanlike because you're trying to force your opponent to.
Interesting, Spencer, interesting. Tyler Stem in a battle here. Incredible battle. Wow. Student section, Trojan student, the student wall. The Trojan wall battling with Tyler, classmate, friend. Oh, nice move by Stemmy.
Nice little trip back.
Let's go, T-Stem. You work, T-Stem.
I lost it right there. Gotta stay smart. Yeah, you gotta stay smart right here. Not allow that takedown.
Oh no,
he's got to work back up. Yeah.
Good job.
They can't allow a major. Simsbury cannot allow a major here.
Absolutely. They'll tie it up, Rick.
Mm. 40 seconds left here in the second.
A pin is 6 points.
Yep.
The lead right now, is six points.
Ty really needs to get one. He needs to escape here. That's very important.
40 seconds in the second period.
He's got to escape here and then escape, choose in the third period and escape out.
Wow.
All right, he's got his one, good. We got to keep it away from Major, that's the big part. He's got to stay smart here.
Second period. 8-1. That was a nice escape by Stemmy.
Staying smart.
Yep. Okay.
All right. Simsbury's choice right here. Sim's got to get
what would you
right
do?
Up and out.
What would you do? Go down?
You know what? I would, if I was Stem, just get out and stay safe. Avoid. You gotta avoid that major at all costs right now. All right, see what I have in there? All right,
yeah.
Sim's gotta stay safe for a while here. He's gotta be
smart.
He got
an escape out of
yep.
that.
He's gotta be smart.
That's a big point right there, Brick.
All right, Sim's gotta stay smart here.
We can live with the three.
Yep, three, it's still up in the air. Four, it's still up in the air, but it's a much more dangerous one.
And then Eddie Novak, what a pressure pack. I'm a little nervous about that.
This is a great matchup. Oh, easily the greatest match this gym has ever seen.
Wow.
Greatest wrestling matches.
Oh my goodness.
All right. He's got plenty of time to try to get that escape though. Plenty of time.
You got two for that, Brick.
Yep. So now it's a major right now. He's got to try to escape and get one.
With 1 minute left.
Yeah. That's huge right now. He's got to escape and get that one.
Oh,
looks like he might be trying to duck under it. Smart, he's got his one. He's got to be smart here. That's what it's all about, being smart.
Oh, man. Stall a little, maybe. Yep. Eat some clock.
That's a, well, he's already been called for stalling.
He's already been given a warning.
Yeah.
A warning or a call?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Coach Goodwin and Para. Yeah. Really working
him. He might be trying to get him to get the two. Not able to get it. He's got to be smart. Big.
You got two. 19 seconds. He needs two.
He needs two. He's in a very, very, very dangerous situation right here. He needs two.
Get in right here. Coach Goodwin, Coach Novak, Coach Goodwin and Eddie Novak. That's
and
the last wrestler right there.
This is a much closer match.
Eddie Novak.
This is a huge match.
Let me tell you something. If it ever boiled down to anybody on this Trojan team, I'd be picking Eddie Novak.
I'd want Eddie.
Wow. Spencer, unbelievable.
Yeah.
Eddie Novak, senior, oh, the money.
This gym is alive.
We got a two-point lead, though, Brick.
We only got two. We need more.
We already got two. Nothing.
Here's big Eddie Novak, coach of a lot of baseball and basketball.
Kid.
One of my favorites. Great athlete. Unbelievable athlete. Played basketball, baseball, football, soccer, and wrestling in Simsbury. He could play any sport.
He gets this win here, biggest win of his entire career on his senior night. That's huge.
I would say it's the biggest athletic accomplishment in his career in high school.
Possibly, yes.
And he's got a lot.
Yep.
He's an absolute animal.
Yep.
What's the weight class, Brick?
This is 160.
160's all Eddie weighs?
Mm-hmm.
That's a nasty 160. Let's go, Big E! Let's go, E! Wow. Can they hear anything, Spence, right now?
They can hear, yeah. There's holes in the side specifically, so they can mostly, it's mostly for hearing your coach, you know what I mean?
Of course.
Yeah. They can still hear the chants.
Yeah.
They can feel them.
I don't know where his mom and dad, Christine and Ed, are, but they've got to be sweating right now. Christine Novak, Ed Novak, two great parents. Eddie, you got it, baby. Let's ride the E train tonight. Only a second year wrestling, I think.
Yeah, he's a powerful, strong wrestler.
Only a second year. Wow, a little hand-holding.
Mm-hmm. Trying to get them out of each other out of position.
Interesting. That was weird.
16 seconds left in this first.
With a two-point lead, a three-point win match takes it for Farmington.
Exactly. That's why Simsbury needs this win here. This is...
Whoever wins this match wins the whole thing.
Yep.
There's no halfway. There's no score, right?
Nope. It's right here. This is the decider.
Unbelievable.
Oh,
this
yeah.
is incredible.
This is the definition of a dogfight.
Oh. This is absolutely more than I anticipated. Stop? What was that?
Yeah. That was...
What's up?
He stepped back, pretty much didn't allow Eddie to get anywhere near him. A lot of times they'll call it for stalling, but again, it's up in the air with that.
Okay. Well, that ends the first period. Come on, E. Come on, E. Oh, Eddie! No points? A parent wanted
no
a
points,
foul
yeah.
on that. Some parent was up saying it was a foul. No, he still had him tight.
Oh, yeah, no. It was fine. He followed him down to the mat.
Exactly.
That's the important part.
Exactly. That's very important that he keep his composure on things
exactly,
like that.
Yeah. You need to stay confident right now. That's all it's about is confidence.
Here we go, Big E. Right here, E.
Escape.
That's not going to mean anything. Folks, you're seeing an incredible match here tonight. Good move,
Ed. Beautiful double. Oh. Oh, he almost got it.
Oh, oh boy, good escape by that Farmington wrestler. Yep.
Good motion from both wrestlers.
Yep. Let's go, E. No. Come on, E. Come on, brother. Come on, Eddie. Minute 15 left in the second period. Wow. Who would have thought it'd come down to this, Spence, at one point when we had that 10-point lead?
This is down to the wire.
This gym is rocking. Just a 1-point score. That's it. Farmington wrestler, what we call
seconds.
In base basketball, he seems a little chippy.
Mm-hmm.
A little chippy.
Good motion.
...23-21 Simsbury lead. Eddie's get it, Eddie. Get him, Eddie.
Nope, nothing. He's not able to get anything yet. He's staying strong on that wizard.
That's
the right thing
tough.
To do. Yep.
That Farmington kid's tough.
Eddie's just as tough back.
Oh, no doubt.
Oh, he's willing to give every last thing in his body.
I just know how tough Eddie is.
Oh, yeah.
This kid's even hanging with him. He's got my respect.
Mm-hmm.
Just because I know how tough he is.
To the third.
Oh, 1-0.
Oh yeah, this is, can't get any closer than this.
Folks, this is incredible. Come on, Eddie. Trojan Nation.
He's got his one. That was a
All
good
right.
one.
All right. Nice. Oh, they're still going.
Yep.
He got an escape to tie it up.
Yeah. All right. We're all tied up right here.
Wow.
This is the greatest match I have ever seen. I can tell you that much.
Wow, Spencer. And
I've never seen
you,
it brought
seen
down
lot.
To the wire like this before.
Oh, my goodness. A minute 39 seconds.
Oh, yeah.
1-1. Unbelievable. It all rides on this match.
Yep.
Eddie Novak, the 160-pound senior, only been wrestling 2 years. Just an incredible all-around athlete fighting for Coach Goodwin, Coach Para, the Simsbury Nation, right here, Trojan Nation.
Just I mean, if you could say there was a Rocky Balboa of wrestling, it would be Eddie. Just so tenacious, so strong, willing to give every last bit.
Minute 12, 1-1.
Minute 12, ooh.
We could see OT maybe, Spence. Could you imagine if it goes to sudden death?
Oh, gosh. It's almost unfair to my heart.
Unreal. I just pulled the cord out of my headset. I was so excited. Adam Rozdowski getting you the action like a professional that he is. Thank you, Roz, for coming out tonight. Allowed Mr. Homecamp a rest. 1 minute left. 1 minute.
So close.
brutal. I can't imagine what's going through those wrestlers' minds. Win or lose, they are winners.
Oh, yeah. Just so much pressure on both wrestlers.
Too much,
you know?
Too much. I don't like it, actually, yeah. Spencer, to be honest. It makes me uncomfortable.
I'll agree with that. 35 seconds left.
Let's go.
Oh. Smart. He's got.
Jesus. Take us through it, Spence. Yep.
He might. He's trying to look for that. Oh, no. He's going to look at it. 19 seconds. Okay.
What are we doing?
Heart's going.
I know.
Oh, yeah. This is. Both these guys are so tough. They want this win. You can tell. But
10 seconds.
They're both so tired. They've both been working so hard this season. Both guys want to make their team end undefeated. They want it so bad.
3, 2, 1.
We're going into overtime.
Sudden death the first minute.
Yeah.
Oh. Sudden death. Number 2, number 3 in the state. Farmington, Simsbury.
So close.
Yeah. First point wins.
Oh, yeah.
Even if it's an escape.
One more point. Just one takedown is what these guys need.
Yes, it is. I'd rather have us win on a takedown.
Oh, yeah.
Just seems like a tough way to lose off an escape.
Yep.
Farmington goes low.
Yep, not able to get it. And sometimes the wrestler is ready for it.
Come on, Eddie. You work, kid. Dig in, Ed.
Looks like he might be trying to get something.
Oh. Okay. All right. Stay cool. Stay
18
cool.
18 seconds.
18 seconds and sudden death. For both wrestlers' sake, I prefer just get out of this portion.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to see anything happen. Anybody here? These guys work too hard.
5 seconds left. Looks like we're going to double overtime. This might be a double or triple overtime ending.
Unbelievable. This is incredible. OT. Our second OT. First one. This is not sudden death. The previous overtime we saw tonight was
25 seconds.
Christian Kylide won 3-2 in overtime at the unlimited weight class of the 285. Oh, yeah. 25 seconds. It all comes down to this match. Or get him, Ed.
He's got a single. That's good. It's smart. Smart wrestling. 15 seconds left. Just the heart of these two wrestlers. Oh, willing to give everything they got.
I'm not sure I signed up for this, Brick. Wow. Okay, easy.
9 seconds left.
9 seconds. Oh, that's a good spot,
yep.
Spencer.
It's a good spot. True.
Come on, Eddie! 2 seconds.
Time.
What, he thought he had an escape or something?
No. He's got 30 seconds here. He's got to try to escape. 30 seconds to escape.
He's got, this is it.
This is it. This is everything. This is everything. He's able to escape. He's got 20 seconds, plenty of time.
He's got to get up.
Yep.
And bust free.
Bust through. He's got it right here.
Seconds.
He's got to be strong. He's got to get everything he's got.
How do you get out of that bear hug?
He's got it. Okay. He's in a good position.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right.
What's that, Spencer?
We're going to triple.
So he doesn't get a point for that, though.
No.
We don't gain a point.
Yeah. Triple overtime.
Guy?
This is, if he can stay on top, he wins.
Oh, goodness. This is ridiculous.
This is, I didn't tell you that much. Oh, God.
This is crazy. Oh. Escape?
Yeah, that was an escape.
That's one way I just didn't want anybody to win. I just don't understand that particular. To win that way is, to me, very difficult.
Yeah.
It just doesn't seem right.
It's a rough way to win. Or a rough way to lose, really.
Either one. Oh, what a match. Great fight by Eddie Novak. Great fight by all the Trojan wrestlers. And the good news, the season does not end there. There's still wrestling to be done. What an exciting evening of incredible athletic desire. Coach Ernie Goodwin guiding his Trojan grapplers to S. Spencer Bricky, former wrestler himself here. You've seen more wrestling. You've forgotten more wrestling than I've ever seen, Spence. And for you to say this was the most critical, epic match on Simsbury property here is incredible.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what Coach Goodwin has to take to the boys now in his post-match talk.
Yeah.
He's got to make sure Eddie is cool.
Yep.
Did Eddie go through the handshake line? I didn't see. I hope he did. Didn't see, but I'm pretty sure he did.
Mm-hmm.
That's real important. We have to remain calm and cool, keep our composure. There's Coach Goodwin talking to the official there, and just all the fans filing out. So Spencer, why don't you take over our closing comments?
All right. So again, that was last match of the actual season for the Simsbury wrestlers. Now we go into postseason. From here on out, we have CCC to start. We'll see if that still remains with the snowstorm. Mm-hmm. But from there, we go to double L's. Mm-hmm. Those who can proceed from double L's go to state opens, and those who proceed from there go to New England. So again, they still have a lot of wrestling still left to go, and they're still willing to keep pushing on through and try to make some big wins there, though.
So, Spencer, is this it from a team standpoint? Is all the rest individual?
Well, actually, no. From here, teams can still win double L's and state open.
Okay. So this isn't the end of possibly being number one in a state.
No, it is not. If we still see the number one at double L's. If we're able to win double L's, we can still take that top spot.
And that's because Farmington's in Class L.
Yes.
And Danbury, what class are they?
Double S.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Danbury. Okay. Yep. Well, Adam Razdowski, thank you for working with us. Spencer, I just want to thank you, and I just want to compliment you on your excellent, excellent knowledge and skill and just working with me tonight. I've enjoyed this thoroughly. I know we're both disappointed about the outcome, but I want to thank you and honored that you and Coach Goody and Coach Perry and John Helmkamp and all the wrestlers allowed me to come back and experience this. It was unbelievable. I will not forget this experience.
I thank you once again for being here.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Funding for Simsbury Community Television is provided in part by contributions from viewers like you. Thank you.